Hello. I want to share something really quickly with you all, those who are on a journey of spirituality, dealing with the law of attraction, the law of assumption, and, you know, thoughts creating your reality. I'm sharing this with you because you're a reflection of me, and I want you to get this. I want you to be better than me. It took me a long time to understand this really big part of the journey. So, with the law of attraction, you think, okay, yeah, thoughts create things. Yeah, I understand that. So you go in and you begin to meditate and you try to, you know, deal with your thoughts. But the ones that really are attracting is those habitual thoughts. So it's like the hidden thoughts that you're not speaking. You could do all the I am affirmations. I am healthy. I am wealthy. I'm love. I'm blah, 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 blah. But if you're not penetrated to the subconscious mind, you're not changing your frequency, so to speak, right? So with the law of attraction, they say, you know, you got to be on a certain frequency in order to attract the things that you're wanting. So how do you know you're on that frequency, though? You wake up in the morning, you don't have a meter that you measure the frequency like, hey, am I on love? Am I on joy? Am I on the money one? Because I sure want the money today. Well, here's how you can get a gauge or idea of what frequency you're on if you pay attention to those habitual thoughts. So say, for example, I'm out here and I'm meeting somebody out here to go work out. But I used to have a thought that I was, you know, overweight. I was fat and, you know, maybe nobody's going to like me because I'm too fat. I'm conscious of my weight. So I have this new outfit. I'm going out here to meet a person, and I get out of the car and I say hi to them, and I'll be like, look, you like my new outfit? That first thought. After I say, do you like my new outfit? If your mind goes to, oh my gosh, I'm fat. I hope they don't notice. I feel grossed out about myself. I feel rejected, or whatever it is, that thought that you didn't say while you was looking at that person that comes to mind, whatever it is, that thought is, that's your habitual thought. And that's the one that you have to work on. And that's what I would call a sneaky link. You know, that's the damn sneaky link that's going to the universe and creating your reality. And that's why your relationships are suffering. That's why maybe you get ghosted a lot. Maybe you feel like you're the one that's going to go out and nobody's going to pick you, you know, to come and talk to or buy your drink for. Because you have a habitual thought in that area. And that is your signal. That is what you're attracting. So how do you fix that? You rewrite your story, baby. You rewrite your story. Whatever started this here making you feel like you was fat and unworthy and this and that and the third, you rewrite that story. And you go back. You gotta go back in order to move forward. You go back and write that story, rewrite it, and you remember that story as you being sexy. Like everybody wanting to be around you, that everybody called you. You had so many boyfriends. Everybody loved you because you were so lovable. And you remember that new story. And